Malay woman from Perth. What do you think when you hear some traditional owners intend to vote no?
It's a democracy. People can choose to vote the way that they want to. There's a lot of people that are misinformed about the information that's out there right now, so it's really quite concerning. But what I do encourage people, have a look at both sides of the argument and then come in informed. That's really quite important in that respect.
How are you going to vote?
I came out initially said no. And I said no for a number of reasons. One is that there was not enough detail in relation to it. There was this idea about having a voice, but I had no idea what that would actually look like. In terms of constitutional, the constitution's already racist. You only have to look at the two provisions, section 51, 26, and also 25. So there were some issues there. So I came out, organised some rallies, no, not voting, don't know enough about it. And there were other reasons as well why I chose the vote no, because it wasn't any communication, there was lack of consultation. What I have done since then, and I've spoken to different activist groups that I'm aligned with, and brothers and sisters and so forth, people in the prisons, people that have had their children taken from them at hospital, at birth, and it's absolutely cruel in terms of devastation that's being inflicted upon our people right now across the country. I'm now voting yes. And the reason for that is because we have no central body. So what I'm saying in terms of one coordinated place, one coordinated approach, one central body, we're lacking that right now.
Was there a particular catalyst that changed your mind?
Yeah, there was. So, suicides. That is what changed my mind. A little boy who went into care as a six-year-old. He lost his brother to suicide at the age of 10 years old. He lost his own life at the age of 23, leaving behind two little children. Another little fellow came out of the prison, 18 months, no longer here. It was because of these two little fellows, and you see the tears and the hurt and the agony and the pain. This, our country, to say that we're dividing it even further, we're already divided. That's the reality. At the end of the day, we're all brothers and sisters of the human family, and the bar, it is so low. All it is asking for that advisory body, and if we can include other people from remote so they can speak to their issues, you know, that is a good thing. It's the start in a long journey.
Can I ask you?